Hey guys, welcome to the session by Intellipaat. Today we are going to learn what is Data Factory and why do we need to use Data Factory. After learning about Data Factory, you will be learning the working process of Data Factory. Once you are clear with the working process, you will be getting introduced to Data Lake. After getting introduced to Data Lake, you will be learning how to copy data from Azure SQL to Azure Data Lake. After learning the copying process, you will be learning the visualization part, how to load data from Data Lake to Power BI. After learning the visualization part, you will be learning how to create ETL process by creating a pipeline in Data Factory. By the end of this video, you will be able to use Data Factory for automating the data movement and data transformation. Now let's see why do we need to use Data Factory. These days, the amount of data generated is really huge and this data comes from different sources. Let's look at an example for better understanding. We are having multiple sources of social media. And we need to collect the time spent by each user on all the platforms per day. Now basically the extracted user details will be in JSON format, which means JavaScript object notation. If we want to perform some analytics on all the users' time period spent on each social media every day, we will be collecting the customer's log files, which will be in flat file, that is text file. Now the data which has been extracted is raw data and cannot be used as it is. So it needs to be cleansed, mapped and then transformed as per our requirements. And then it is loaded into the data warehouse. Now, the storage is connected to an external source like Power BI to perform some analytics. Now, for automating all this workflow and monitor and manage it on daily schedule, we use Data Factory. So, the complete process of extracting, transforming and loading the data into warehouse is called extract, transform and load. The source system keeps on changing, right? So this is a regular process where the data has been regularly fetched from the social media and loaded into warehouse after transformations are complete. So for automating the movement and transformation of this data, we need Data Factory. Let's see what is Data Factory. Data Factory is a cloud-based integration service that orchestrates and automates the movement and transformation of data. It stores the data with the help of data lake storage and many other services. And then it transforms the data with the help of pipeline, where logical grouping of activities that together perform a task. And then it publishes the organized data to the third-party applications like Power BI to perform analytics and visualization. I hope you all are clear with what is Data Factory. Now let's move on to the working process of Data Factory. Input data is the data that we have within our data store. Now let's say we are collecting the data set from IMDb website to perform visualization based on movie rating. And this is the sample data which we want to transform. This is very basic example which I am showing just for understanding purpose. In actual, the source system keeps on changing. It is a regular process where data is fetched continuously, which is really huge. And we need to process this raw data through pipeline. Pipeline basically performs an operation on the data, which could be anything like data movement or data transformation. And now let's see how it works. Now I want the list of movies to be reviewed on the basis of rating whether it is worst or average or good. And now this transformation is performed in pipeline. Data transformation is possible with the help of USQL or some stored procedures or Hive. After this is done, you will get an output data. And this output data will contain data that is in structured form because it is already transformed and made structured in the pipeline stage itself. And now here is the list of movies which are transformed based on the rating which we have provided in raw data. And then it is sent to linked services like Data Lake or Blob Storage or SQL. And now what it does is, it stores the information and then it connects to an external source like Power BI. And now we are publishing our output data with a list of movies reviewed to Power BI for performing visualization. It is similar to the concept of SQL Server. In SQL Server, we know how to mention the source and destination of data. We need a connection string so that we can connect to an external device. We just need to mention the source and destination of our data. And this is how linked services work. And then comes the optional gateway. If you want to connect your on-premises system, then you need to install self-hosted integration runtime so that you can connect it to Azure Cloud. And finally, we need a BI tool. We visualize and analyze the transformed data which is published with the help of Power BI or Tableau. Input data set comprises of various sources. You can have data coming from Facebook, Twitter and so on. Now collect all this data and store it at one location. Now let's say we are storing the data in data warehouse. Now we need to transform this data through pipeline. As the data is coming from different sources, which is raw data, we need a NoSQL data store with huge amount of storage. For this,
Azure provides data lake storage.
I hope you all are clear with working process of Data Factory. Now let's see how to copy data from Azure SQL to Azure Data Lake. We all are aware of SQL, right? But we are new to Data Lake. Data Lake is much different from Data Warehouse since they allow data to be in raw format without converting and analyzing first. Data Lake is a data storage or a file system which is highly scalable and distributed. It is in the cloud and works with multiple analytic frameworks, which are external frameworks like Power BI, Tableau. And there are two main concepts when it comes to Data Lake. One is storage and another one is analytics. Now storage is of unlimited size. It can be terabytes, gigabytes or petabytes. It shows wide variety of data. It could be structured or unstructured, and it can store really large files. And another concept when it comes to detailing is analytics. Now Data Lake Analytics is a distributed analytics service. When we talk about analytics, we are talking about big data as a service. We will discuss regarding this topic in further lecture. I hope you all are clear with Data Lake. Now let's move on to the copying process. We need to create a new data warehouse in Azure, and then we need to install SQL Server Management Studio in our system to connect to an Azure SQL database, and then create a new server in data warehouse. Configure and deploy the server. After the successful deployment, open SSMS and connect to the server created in data warehouse using SQL authentication. Now let's perform hands-on on this operation which we have discussed. Now go to Azure portal and log in with your credentials. Now go to dashboard and then create a new resource, select databases and then create a new SQL data warehouse. As we are not having any resource group before, create a new resource and then create a new data warehouse. Now create a new server. Now configure the performance and then create. Now once the deployment is done, click on go to resource and under the data warehouse which we have created, copy the server name of it and using SQL Server Management Studio, connect to this server. Now under the data warehouse which we have created in Azure, create a new table inside it. Now execute these commands. Now create a new data lake storage and then create a new data factory. Now mention the source data store and create linked service for it. And then mention the destination data store and create linked service for it. Now let's perform hands-on on this operation which we have discussed now. And then go to Azure dashboard and then click on all services and click on storage and select data lake storage. Now create a new data lake storage. Now fill the details. We have already created a resource before, right? Select it and then create. Once the deployment of data lake is successful, create a new data factory. Now go to all services and then select data factory and create a new data factory. Now fill all those details. And use existing resource and use the latest version for this. That is version 2. I am not enabling Git for this. After the deployment of Data Factory, click on Go to Resource and then click on Author and Monitor. Now select Copy Data. Now assign the task name for this and run it. Now select the source data store, which is Data Warehouse, and create a new linked service for this, which is Data Warehouse. If you want to connect your on-premise system, then you need to install self-hosted integration runtime. As we are not using our on-premise, we are using cloud data warehouse only, so we don't need to install it. And then we have already created our server. Now test the connection. So the connection is successful. And then click on next. Now select the database which we have created. And this is the data set which we have created. You can see your data set which we have created here. So click on next and then mention the destination data store, which is our data lake. And create a new linked service for this, which is data lake. Now mention the name of the linked service and then choose the subscription, which is free trial. Now choose the data lake store account name and coming to authentication type, choose it as service principal ID. And now I'll show you how to generate this service principal ID. Now come back to Azure dashboard and select Azure Active Directory and then select app registrations. Now create a new web application over here. Let me write it as sample application and then register it. Now this application ID is my service principal ID and copy it over the clipboard and then paste it over here. Now coming to service principal key, go to the certificates and secrets. Under client secrets, add a new client secret and then add it over here. And this is the password for you. Copy it and paste it over here. Now test the connection. Now this connection is failed because of access privileges in data lake store. Now let's fix it. Go to all services, storage, data lake storage, and then explore the data. Now go to access and then add it. Our application ID is sample application is the name of our application, right? Here is it. Select it. Now add all the permissions. Now test the connection. Here it is. It worked. Now let's select the destination data store. Click on next. You can skip this because you will have a default output path. Now the file format is text format. And the column delimiter is comma and row delimiter is auto detected, and click on next. You can skip the staging, and here the deployment is complete. You can edit this pipeline as well as you can monitor it too. Now let's see whether this copying process is done or no. Go to all services, storage, data lake storage, explore the data, and finally our data is copied. I hope you all are clear with the copying process. Now let's see how to load data from data lake to Power BI. Before moving on to the topic, let's talk about Power BI. Power BI is a cloud-based business analytics service for analyzing and visualizing the data. Now let's discuss the processes in Power BI. It is used for connecting to your data and for shaping of the data, which means transforming the data like renaming columns or tables, changing text to numbers, removing rows, and so on. And then modeling of data, which means relationship which defines how data sources are connected with each other. And then data visualization, which means creating charts or graphs to provide visuals of the data. And then publishing data reports. Now let's move on to the loading process. First of all, download Power BI Desktop from the mentioned link. And then go to Azure Dashboard and create a new data lake store. And then upload the data set. And then open Power BI. Connect to the data lake store in Power BI with a URL provided by data lake store. And then edit query to import data from binary column. And then select the columns from the data set, whichever you want to visualize. And then create visualization. Now go to data lake storage and upload the data set. If you remember, we have already created the data lake storage before. Explore the data now and upload the data set. Now uploading is successfully completed. Now close this and go back to the data set properties which we have created. Now copy this path and open Power BI. Now click on get data and select the data store as data lake. Now connect to it. Now paste the path which we have copied over Azure portal. And now you need to sign in with your Azure credentials. Now load the data. Now if you want to edit your data, click on edit queries. And here is the data set which I have uploaded. So now you need to visualize this data. Now select the columns whichever we want to visualize. And these are the various kinds of graphs and charts which you want. You can choose any of these. I hope you all are clear with how to load data from data lake to Power BI. Now let's see how to create a pipeline using Data Factory. Creating a pipeline is listed as one of the steps in performing ETL solution. Now we have SQL database and we are trying to extract some data from this database. We will be extracting, and if something has to be processed, then it will be processed and then store it in data lake. Now let's see the steps for creating ETL solution. First of all, we will be creating a linked service for SQL Server database and then create a linked service for data lake store. Now create a data set for data extraction. And then create a data set for data saving. Now create the pipeline and add the copy activity. Finally, schedule the pipeline by adding trigger. Now let's get back to the quiz with few questions. Your first question is, which of the following is not a linked service in Data Factory? Is it Data Lake or Power BI or SQL Data Warehouse or Blob Storage? Now comment your answer below the comment box. Coming to your second question, which of this tool is used for visualizing the data? And your options are SQL, Tableau, C#, Data Lake. And comment your answer below the comment box.
I hope this session was informative for you all. If you have any doubts, please feel free to comment below. Thank you.